Today on our trailer, we're going to be installing the Hopkins Trailer Breakaway Kit with a charger. Part number HM20001. We're going to mount the battery box here to the trailer jack itself using the U-bolts and the other supplied hardware. Go ahead and turn the battery box around like this. We'll then take a U-bolt, slide it into position, then take a flat washer, put that in place, then put a nylon lock nut. Go ahead and repeat that for the other side of the U-bolt. We'll then go ahead and raise the battery box up just a little bit so we can install the lower U-bolt. Go ahead and put our flat washers on and again our nylon lock nuts. Now we'll go ahead and tighten down the nuts on our U-bolts. We'll need to kind of hold the battery box as we tighten them down, and you want to alternate between the two sides of the U-bolt as you're tightening things down. As you can see here now, our battery box is nice and secured to the trailer jack itself. So next we're going to need to route our three wires here. There's a blue, a black, and a white. Now we're going to go ahead and drill a hole here through this plate in the trailer so we can route these three wires down underneath. Next we're going to put a little bit of 1/4-inch wire loom, part number 7509-10, on our three wires here as we route it through the hole we just drilled. Go ahead and put a little bit of electrical tape here on the wires and wire loom to keep it in place. Now we're ready to go underneath the trailer here and make our other connections. We're going to go ahead and use a couple zip ties to help secure some of the wire as well. Go ahead and trim off any excess zip tie to clean up our look. Go ahead and trim our white wire down to length, and then we'll add our ring terminal to it. Strip a little wire back. Put our ring terminal on. Then we'll crimp it down. We'll then need to undo this ground real quick so we can add our ground in place. Next, we're going to go ahead and add a little bit more wire here to our black wire. We'll do this just using a heat shrink style butt connector. Both of our wires strip back. We'll go ahead and add our butt connector in and we'll crimp it down. Go ahead and heat seal off our butt connector, either using a cigarette lighter or a heat gun. Heat gun is preferred. Now we'll go ahead and take our black wire and we'll route it over here to the junction box. Go ahead and trim our wire down a little bit to the correct length. We're going to feed it in with the other wires through this grommet here on the end. We got to loosen up the relief piece here that keeps the wires tight. There's two screws in this box that hold that in place. Now we're going to need to add a ring terminal here to the end of our wire. Go ahead and crimp it down then. And then we'll be adding it in on this box to the charge circuit, which is this one right here on this box. Now that we have that one added in, next we're going to need to go ahead and tie in our breakaway switch itself. Now we're going to need to mount this breakaway switch here to the tongue on the trailer. We're going to go ahead and drill a hole. Now it'll line up here, and our two wires, we're actually going to use one of these existing holes and feed our two wires through. We're going to go ahead and put a little electrical tape where the wires will go through to protect them so they don't get messed up. Feed both of our wires through here. Go ahead and take our screw here. I'll go on the underside and put a nut on the back side of the screw. Now before we make the rest of our connections, we're going to go ahead and plug the breakaway cable in here to the breakaway switch. Simply line it up, push it all the way in place. Then just kind of wrap the excess cable around our trailer jack for now, just to keep it out of the way. Now we're going to go ahead and connect our blue wire here off the breakaway switch to the blue wire coming off of the battery box. Go ahead and get our length and cut it down and strip our wire back. Add our butt connector in and crimp it down. Now for the black wire, we're going to have to again add a piece of extra wire, as this will run over here to our junction box where we'll tie it in with the brake circuit. Go ahead and add our extension of black wire in to the black wire. Do that by stripping back both ends of the wire and then adding in a butt connector. With our butt connectors crimped down, we'll go ahead and seal them up using a heat source, either a cigarette lighter or a heat gun. We're going to go ahead and take some electrical tape to give our connections a little more protection. Go ahead and use a couple zip ties to help secure our wire as we route it over to the junction box. Go ahead and trim off our excess zip ties. This is the brake circuit in this junction box, so we'll be going to right there. We'll go ahead and remove the nut and the star washer off of our post here. Go ahead and trim our wire to length. We'll strip it back and then we'll add a ring terminal. Go ahead and add it in line there. Then we'll put our star washer and our nut back in place. Once that's done, we'll go ahead and tighten back up our bracket here that holds the wires nice and tight and keeps them from backing out of the box. And then we can put our cover back on. Now here's what we did. We pulled this pin right here that's in the breakaway switch out, so we were spinning the wheel to make sure everything worked. Simply go like that, and it engages the brakes. So with the cable and the pin back in the breakaway switch, you can see it's spinning again. This cable here will be attached to your tow vehicle in case if the trailer would come unhitched from your tow vehicle, the pin would be pulled and the trailer brakes would be applied. And that'll do it for the installation of the Hopkins Trailer Breakaway Kit with a charger, part number HM20001, on our trailer.